In this video, we'll understand regression testing. Change happens and most developers are sure to work on a project that requires revisions to the current version of the software, or maybe they are working for a startup and it's adding new features on a monthly or even a weekly basis. When you start to introduce changes to the system, you need to be aware of how this could affect our existing parts of your system. You could be very well introducing new problems to the software without you realizing that you have done it. When you test your application to make sure changes to the code haven't broken the existing code, well, this is called regression testing. In this video demonstration, we would like to perform some changes to the existing code, and then we will perform automated regression testing in order to make sure that our system is intact. To get started, we'll open Visual Studio 2012 and we have a software known as integration test, which we have coded in the last a few demonstrations. We'll double click on form.cs file, wherein you'll get the user interface of the software, and program.cs is the coding file wherein we have the initial startup of our application, and within the form 1 we have our code available. So this code, what it displays, we have a button control. As soon as we click on the button control, we are going to fetch two integers a and b, and we are going to perform some calculations on a and b. Let's say calculations is a class which is delivered to us by some other software developer. So during integration of the software, it may be possible that he has performed some changes to the system, and after performing changes to the system, we have to make sure whether our system is intact after the changes are introduced into the system. So let's say the other developer has added a few new methods within this application code. Let's say they have introduced public integer subtract, and let's say what this system does, it does integer a comma integer b, and it returns a minus b. So let's say we have got a new method introduced in calculation.cs file, and this calculation.cs is integrated into the integration test project. Now what next we need to do is we have to make sure whether after this change has been introduced into the system, our system is intact. That means the system behavior is exactly same as it was before introduction of this software, or before introduction of this piece of code within calculation.cs. So we have to make sure that our system passes our user interface test, and we are going to perform that test automatically. So let's see how we can do that. In the previous session, we have recorded an automated video, so we are going to make use of that automated recording. We are going to make use of the automated recording, and we are going to generate automated test using these recordings, and then we are going to test our new software which is introduced with changes using our automated testing. So to get started, let's say we are going to test this integration test application, and let's say we are running the application, some code has been introduced, and finally a build has been generated and a software is ready. So since your software is ready here, we have to make sure after introduction of new methods within our integration test application, once we will perform regression testing in order to make sure that after introduction of the changes, program behavior is exactly same, like it does perform the actual things which it is required to do. So we are going to get started with coded UI test. For this, we are going to start a new Visual Studio project. Let's say we have started a new Visual Studio, and we are going to perform an automated regression testing on this software. To do that, we are going to create a new project, and we are going to call this project as a test project, and let's call this project as a regression, automated regression test. Let's click on OK. So as soon as we created OK, The project will be created, and now it is asking to generate code for the coded UI test. We can generate the coded UI test either by recording the actions. These will be new actions which we may record, so we'll address this option in couple of videos coming soon. At the moment, we are going to make use of existing action recording, and we are going to test our integration test application under regression testing using our existing action recordings which have been recorded earlier. So let's click on use an existing action recording. Let's click on OK. We have to connect to our Team Foundation server where our recordings are available. That means where our test cases are available. So we have the URL hackwithatesting.visual.com. We have connected that. So within that hackwithatesting, we have a project known as my first project. Let's connect to the project. Within this project, we have multiple test cases. Now we have to search for the test cases which we want to test on our integration test application. So we can go to title contains, we can search for the test cases, and in order to search for the test cases, let's get started with Microsoft Test Manager. Using Microsoft Test Manager, we'll identify name of the test which we have recorded earlier, and we are going to perform those tests on our integration test application. So here, as soon as you can see, we have our testing center ready. So name of the test is acceptance testing, which is available in our case. So we are going to make use of acceptance testing, and we are going to search for acceptance testing within our regression tool. Acceptance testing. Let's find. So you have got acceptance testing cases. So last time once we have did acceptance testing, we are going to make use of the same actions, and we are going to use the actions to be executed over your regression testing case. So let's click on acceptance testing, click on OK. Now you can see that within this coded UI test method, automatically the methods will be generated. And here you can see that using the video recording, which has been recorded using Microsoft Test Manager in the last video, we have got these methods automatically created within our coded UI test method. And now we are going to test these methods, and we are going to test whether the test is passed or not. So we have got some method exchange. Let's test after introduction of the subtract method. Is everything going fine? So we'll right click on this. Let's run test. As soon as we click on run test, automated regression testing project has started. It has succeeded, and we have to perform the test over this integration test application. So I hope you understood how the test has been created, and now we are automatically testing the project. This test is automatically being performed depending on the values provided to the system in the last test case. So here you can see that as soon as we executed the test has been done, and it took 13 seconds to pass the test, and the test has been passed. So that means after introduction of the new method, that is subtract, the system is intact and the regression testing has been performed. So let's do quickly a few other changes and to see whether in which case the application will fail. So let's say we have the subtract method, or now let's say we'll go to program.cs file or our form.cs file wherein we have the add method, and let's say we are going to convert that add method into subtract method. We are going to save it, we are going to publish it, and now we are going to test whether our system is going to pass the test or not. So let's go to the regression test, let's right click on it, run test. And this time we are automatically testing, running the tests again. So integration test will go with some values. Answer is -10. The second value is 50-50 and answer is 0. And the third is, answer is 0. So now whatever the application value is, we can see that we have got that the test has been done. Now we have to make sure whether the third values which have been generated, were they equal or not. So we have to record the videos accordingly. So this is how the tests are done and regression tests are performed. Thank you for watching this video.